the golden age of this whole restoration was, you know, 1980 to 90, you know, and that's when, you know, major renovations were done. I mean, the building was repainted and brought back to its original colors. We had all kinds of people in there doing paint scrapings, you know, down through four or five different layers to say it was originally this color. And if we didn't like that color, we'd say, what was the next one up?
We started looking at the old pictures and saying, okay, scrape over here because we know there's something there. And they'd scrape and pretty soon there was something there. And it was an investigative process that was amazing. It was a lot of fun and it was like, you couldn't wait to get to work the next day to find out what they were gonna find next. It was like a treasure chest of beautiful things on the wall that had been destroyed over 75, 80 years.
You know, so this whole building was probably stenciled at one time, knowing the historic period, knowing the American Renaissance, this was all stenciled. They hired some artists, and they used good common sense. Some of those stencils, you know, when they were just line sort of things, weren't painted, but, you know, put on with, you know, other devices, you know, like markers, etc. But they look, you know, they really add to the whole embellished decor of the building. They needed to come back. A lot of the things that were original to the Capitol were removed. We've had replicas made. So that, you know, it's a combination of what existed, what could be found, and what could be replicated.
Most of the chandeliers that had been there originally had been removed. The rumor is that most of them were during probably the Second World War, but it could have been the first, were taken and melted down and used for shell casings.
Over the years, the massive columns found throughout the Capitol were displaying cracks. Repairing the columns was a challenge because these were not marble columns, but rather scagliola columns, which had become a lost art.
Scagliola is a plaster product that most people can't tell the difference from real marble. Scagliola cost $100 a column in those days. And marble would have cost $1,000. It probably would have lasted forever except the Capitol started settling.
The mosaic floors were also in need of repair. As the legend goes, the floors were laid by 66 Italian workers, each leaving a signature blue tile. Only 55 tiles are visible to the public.
Of course, it always surprised me who some of the legislators that supported the renovation, because some of them are so damn snug they would like spend any money. But they spend quite a lot of money fixing this building, putting back the way it was.
There was no one more conservative and more of a watchdog when it come to state money than my father. He must have felt capital restoration was pretty important because that took a pretty high priority.
Now when I walk in, I feel how pristine and well cared for this building is. How very South Dakota it is. Whatever input, you know, the legislature and initial building committees had, the budget they had, et cetera, the style of the time, but really it's the patina of the years of functioning of the state living in that building. It takes on the personality of the state.
I can't think of anything that we ultimately decided to do that didn't get done. It just took 15 to 20 years to spend $4 million.
Restoration efforts wrapped up in 1989, just in time to celebrate 100 years of statehood.